Hi everyone guys, here we are with my first 2013 video. Today I'm going to teach you how to play American Idiot by Arctic Monkeys. Since all lesson I've done up to now were by Arctic Monkeys, now it's kind of difficult that American Idiot is from Green Day. Yeah, what I was saying, American Idiot, which is a track of the eponymous album American Idiot, which was on 2004, I guess. And this is one of most representative songs of Green Day. And even if I don't really like punk, I pretty like this song because I remember then when I was something like 14 or 15, I had an MP3 player, not the iPod or MP4 or stuff like that, because at that time they didn't exist at all, and I just listened to this song over and over again because I hadn't other songs on it. So anyway, since if you have saw my last video, I told that from now on, I will put 3 songs titles at the end of each video so that you can vote which song you want in the next lesson. I had to choose one song which wasn't on this list of songs that you have requested me in the comments. Okay, you can read it because it's written a little. I don't know what I wanted to say, but I asked to a friend of mine, which is starting to play guitar, and I asked to him which song you want me to do on a lesson, and he said me American Idiot by Green Day. So guys, I hope you enjoy. Wait until the end of the video so that you can choose the next lesson, and that's it. Bye guys. Hi everyone guys, welcome to American Idiot lesson by Green Day. The song is pretty simple, there are just 3 parts: the verse, the chorus and the solo. We start with a verse which will do the introduction, because the verse is always... But in 2 different cases you will play it continuously or just part to part. But now let's get into the song and you will understand. We'll start with the introduction, which will play continuously this for 4 times. So it will be... Okay, what about the play? They are just power chord. The first one you have to take is with your point finger on the 4th fret. Ring finger and pinky will be on the 6th fret of A and D string. After you have played this for twice, you play a muted stroke. So. And after you have played that chord, you have just to play the power chord, which is the same fingering but slightly down to 1 fret, so like this. Point finger will be on the 4th of the A, ring finger and pinky on the 6th of D and G. So then you go here. Point finger on the 2nd fret of E string, ring finger and pinky on the 4th fret of A and D string, and for twice, then you go to the 2nd chord, to the 1st one, and to the last one. So this is the part. Because after you have done this for 4 times, instead of going here, you play open A, D and G string, like this.
Don't wanna be an American idiot. Na 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 na.
So I've shown you the verse too, because as you can see, the verse has the exact same chord as the introduction, but play at rhythm. Because after the phrase of the singer, "Don't wanna be an American idiot," you play for once, you just play first the open strings. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. And after you have played this for 4 times, this is the verse. So as you can see, same chord, same progression as the introduction, but just different rhythm. You don't have to play it continuously, but one at one. Then we go to the chorus, which is something like. Okay, it's pretty simple, just 3 chords. The first one is the second chord of the first part, so point finger on the 4th fret, ring finger and pinky on the 6th fret of A and G, so this one will be on the A string, and you play it on a rhythm like this. The second chord you will play is the exact same first chord of this part, but slide it up to 1 fret. So this is the very first chord of the song, remember? So now it's. Then you go here, this is a new chord. With your point finger, you'll be on the 6th fret of A string. Ring finger and pinky will be on the 8th fret of D and G. So. And then you go back to the second chord of this part and the very first chord I've shown you before. And you repeat this for twice. Okay, after you have played the chorus for twice, as I said, we go to the continuously verse. So it's something like. And then here starts the verse after you have played continuously for twice. So. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. So again, the verse for 4 times as I showed you before, then you will go to the chorus for twice again. And then you go to the continuously play the first part too. For 4 times. Okay, so then what about the solo? Must be something like, excuse me. Something like. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is the solo, and is without doubt the most difficult part of the whole song. But this is the part which is most difficult, because I will zoom a little bit on my hands if I'm able to. Okay, so now you have to do this, play this chord. With your point finger on the 8th fret, you will have to cover the D string, so that will be muted, like this. It doesn't have to play, not like this. The D string doesn't have to play, and then your ring finger will be on the 10th fret of G string. So this is the chord you have to play. Okay, so after you have played this with 8th and 10th, like this, you go to the 6th fret with your pointer finger, and then on the 4th. So then on the 6th fret, like the 8th before, then 8th. 6, 4, 3, so this is the part. 8, 6, 4, 6, 8, 6, 4, 3, referring to the point finger, because the position would always be like this one. Note, muted, note. So then you will do. For 4 times the 3rd fret on G string, then 5th fret on G string, 6th, 5th, 3, excuse me, I just forgot for 1 minute the solo. So after you have played that, you go on the 8th fret and you do this. So playing twice, I'm going to zoom a little bit. So you will do, 8, 8, 8, 8, 9 on the B, 8, 8, 11 on the B, 8, 8, 8 on the E, 8, 8, 11, 9 on the B. So. This is the part, with a little bit of zoom you will understand. And then you do again the first part of the solo. So. And then you do again, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 5, 6, 5, 3. Then you go on the 8th, on the G, and 13. So I will repeat in slow motion the solo. So this is the solo. I hope you understood everything. So if you have some problem, just write me everything. Now there are two guitars. One does. F. for 5 times, and the other one just does at rhythm too. So you can just choose which kind of guitar you can do. I will write both of them on the tab so you can choose. You can both do this part for 5 times or just this. Until it will get again with the chorus, which is this part. Twice, and after this we will go to the final part, which is pretty much similar to the first one. So and this is the final. So after you have done this normal part for 4 times, you go and play the final, which is, and then after you have done this you do. So, the position on A, D, and G, and then up to a fret, by dudes. So, hi again, it's Luigi Green Hat here, and I hope you enjoyed the lesson, I hope you understood everything. If not, just write everything you didn't understand, and I will help you. And now I'm going to say to you, what are the 3 songs which were more requested? And this is, I don't know how to read it, 12 and 51 by the Strokes. Then we have 2 acoustic songs. The one is Suck It and See by Arctic Monkeys. Love is like a studded leather headlock. And My Mistakes Were Made With You by the West Channel Puppets, Masking and Odds Minor. So yeah guys, few clarification about this thing that I haven't given to you in the last video, sorry. The first one is that you can tell me from now to the next week, next 2 weeks, it depends on how many people will vote, which of these 3 songs you want me to do on the next lesson. And the second thing I haven't said to you in the last video was, you can propose songs anytime you want. So if you want me to put into a voting list your song, you can just write in the comment along with the vote or separately, I don't know, just your decision. But if you want me to play a song, you can just ask me to put in voting list the song you want me to do a lesson about. So guys, see you next time and keep following.